And then the OBS disconnected, so I had to restart the stream. Well, whatever. It's fine. Fancy. Come on, jackass. A throne, really?
Oh, how I've waited to see you in person rather than through a screen, Captain Kenny.
Don't get ahead of yourself, General.
Little girl, have you no intention of returning to my side? And you, well, wish to join me?
I want to be with Videl and Miki, not you.
Who'd ever take the side of a man who uses children as tools? People's lives aren't toys for you to play with.
The time for talk has ended. Varia, bestow your power upon me!
Yes, sir.
Varia! No, sis.
Oh, God.
I have no sister. Your orders, General.
She has no sister, she has no pants.
Lend me your power, minion.
Spirit bomb!
Of my creed. Are you ready to die?
Missile gate! Get ready for something.
Surrounded by a force field that's connected to another dimension via space-time symbology. This effectively makes him immune to any type of attack we could throw at him.
So how do we get past it?
The answer to that is, how should I know?
What's the matter? I thought you were supposed to show me the error in my ways. Thanks to you, we were able to solve one of space-time symbology's many mysteries. In order for her powers to activate, certain types of hormones must be secreted in the subject's brain. For example, your subject secreted the necessary hormones, when experiencing strong emotions, such as trust and love. Now that we understand the mechanism, we can easily replicate the process. This can be accomplished with mind control, or by injecting the necessary hormones directly into her system. Take a good long look. This is the face of... the man who tamed space-time symbology.
I feel bad relying on him again. But we have no other choice.
Relia!
Here we go!
Get up. Get up, Relia. You're just gonna leave your sister like this? I'll catch you no matter how many times you fall. Just believe in me and get up. Take control of your own future with Varia.
I believe in you more than anyone in the universe.
Get ready for some pain.
Now go turn Varia back to her normal self.
I'll do it. I'll be the one to save my sister.
What?
Okay, time to throw everything we've got at him.
I can teleport too, man.
Will not be a dull affair. Very well, it is time. Behold the results of our latest symbological research.
I'll transform into a dragon! Or I'll take my shirt off.
Shadow, listen,
Next on the boss. Oh yeah.
Sir, if we go any further, we'll obliterate the subject's gestalt.
Do it! How dare you! Get out of my way, you worthless cretin!
What?
Why did I not do this in the first place? Such constant.
Because you look stupid.
How invigorating.
Like Kingdom Hearts final boss spaceship and some stupid.
Prostrate yourselves before me.
One more time, kiddo, please!
You can use the same method as before.
But here
you go! If I get rid of the force field, you're all going to attack my sister, right? No, I can't do it.
I was planning on attacking the general, not your sister, but...
Can do it.
I tried to protect you. but this is the end of the road for me. Sorry.
I applaud your will to rise. Well, too bad you'll just be cut back down.
Open your eyes, Faria, please.
No!
Aurelia, I beg of you, please, please kill me.
Don't run away. Fight! Fight against his control! Break free of it!
Silence, whelp!
I believe in you, Aurelia. I always have. And I know you can rise up with Faria if you truly want to.
We can beat this man if we fight together, Faria. I believe in you, sis. And I believe in both of you. I do.
I was confused about main characters this entire time. Who would have thought that the Kenny wasn't the main character of a Star Ocean? Transmogrified Alma. Thank you, Bill Larson, for making that word. I think you might have been the first one to use that word.
Yeah.
gate!
I'm busy. That move, that burst.
did win, didn't we?
Yes. That we did.
His strength is dwindling. His wave patterns are getting astonishingly small.
Luna! Chris! Kronos is destined to crumble! Should I perish here?
Brawn alone can't win all wars.
Likewise, my fascist assailants. I'll be observing your lot from on high. Repudiation to you. An honor to Kronos!
So how you doing?
Fidel, thanks a lot. It didn't back down at all. I did all I could. Me and Relia.
Yeah. You prevailed.
Promise you will. Look after my baby sister.
I certainly do. Relia deserves a good life. A caring, maybe mentoring dad. Like Beryl was when I was young.
Relia, I'm so sorry. What's more, I should thank you. My wish was answered due to your... Grow up and be... the joyous girl I couldn't. Varian, no!
Oh god.
Don't be so sad. Since I'll be with you in your heart.
Captain's log. Space date, November 7, 537. Our mission in the Fate Creed system has concluded. With the death of its leader, General Alma, the rebellion collapsed in upon itself. As the coup d'etat ended in abject failure, the Kronos government was able to regain its authority. Days later, President Mutal declared that Kronos would join the Pan-Galactic Federation, thus swelling our ranks and leaving one fewer enemy. I have a feeling, however, that there will be repercussions from this incident that last for quite some time. In my opinion, it is now abundantly clear that the Federation is at a major crossroads. It is only a matter of time, I assume, before we must re-evaluate the form we wish the Federation to henceforth take.
Look at that hairstyle.
Kronos was officially inducted into the Pan-Galactic Federation. And while the Kronos incident that engendered the Alliance was certainly noteworthy, it was not the only seminal event of Space Date 537. The year also became known for various progressive reforms, which would serve as defining points of Federation policy for years to come. Fae Creed's fate regarding the Federation was officially decided today. Because the planet is not sufficiently civilized, it will not be recognized as a legitimate member of the Federation. As we influenced the planet to a great
extent,
though,
it was
designated a protectorate. I plan to ask Command to appoint Victor the Inspector General of Fae Creed. I cannot imagine there is anyone else in the galaxy better suited to the job than him. Now that I mention one Fae Creed, I should probably record what happened to the rest. Everyone involved in the incident immigrated to Earth.
Oh.
After all they'd experienced of the outside world, we couldn't simply let them return to an underdeveloped planet. Besides, they unanimously decided to come of their own accord, which is what I was hoping for anyway.
They couldn't come back to the planet, so here's a picture of all of them on the planet.
Miki's currently studying her heart out to become a science officer. According to Anne, she's got a real knack for this sort of thing. Already understanding the basics of symbology doesn't hurt either. If there's anything that holds her back, though, it's reading and writing. You can't be too hard on her, as she didn't grow up with the Terran syllabary. But she still has a long road ahead of her. Victor was able to enlist in the Federation's military. And based upon his distinguished record, he was appointed as an instructor. Considering he's a citizen of an underdeveloped planet, this is a historic accomplishment for him. Personally, I'd like to see Command put him in charge of overseeing his home planet, but the decision ultimately rests with him. Thanks in part to an endorsement from Dr. Krug, Fiore was accepted as a researcher in the newly built Symbological Genetics Laboratory on Moonbase. I say accepted, but the whole facility was basically established for her sake. Her knowledge surpasses even our own scientists in some areas, so I assume they're more than happy to take advantage of her genius.
There's and no her fashion sense.
Few breakthroughs with her working on their team. All is quiet on the Anne front, as she continues to work as a science officer aboard the Charles D. Gold. Her looks are what sealed the deal for me when hiring her. But I'll be damned if she isn't one capable science officer. Once I'm finally given my new assignment, I won't hesitate to bring her along. As for me, the myriad and valiant deeds I performed in quelling the Kronos Rebellion earned me a promotion.
Yay!
Nothing's official yet, but word around the water cooler is that I'll become an admiral. To think, me, with my own fleet. What's more, the ship they'll assign me won't be any ordinary one. It'll supposedly be equipped with some rather snazzy technology, of an experimental and gravitic warp kind. I guess this goes to show, you can't make an omelet without breaking a few rules.
Okay, play recording, pause. Ha! That was cool. They left a couple unexplained questions, though. Rather, left a couple of questions unexplained. Fidel and Rilia, I assume will appear after the credits. But about that entire gateway thing inside the planet Faecreed that looks remarkably like the gateway to the fourth dimension in Star Ocean 3. You gotta mention that? No? Nothing? After the NCR victory at Hoover Dam, the temporary truce between them and the Kings blossomed into a full-scale relief effort for the people. While the NCR made repeated entreaties to the Freeside for them to join the Republic, the Kings steadfastly maintained their independence. And war. War never changes. Crispin Freeman, what's Victor Oakville? I think I recognize that voice. They also never explained who, Fiore's significant other or interest in other was or is. I wonder if they ran out of time. After Starship 4, I don't see Square Enix being very, generous to the Star Ocean series. Based upon Star Ocean, Interior Fifth Assist, the original story written by Yoshiharu Rotanda. And after we see all of the everything, and now I'm done for tonight. So, despite what reviewers may have written or said, I enjoy this game. The storyline was interesting. The space stuff more interesting than the medieval planet stuff, that tends to be the case a lot of the time in Star Ocean. Once again, this game continued the Star Ocean tradition of saying it's a space RPG, but you are in fact always stuck on a medieval planet, but I knew that would happen. I'm not going to consider that a fault or anything, or faulty advertising. It's Star Ocean, it's just how it is. Star Ocean 4 was the more space-centered one. And they saw how well that turned out. The combat was a little simplistic, but whatever, it worked. And I liked how fast it was, especially going into and out of combat. I'm not sure how varied the endings are, based on the private actions. But the private actions themselves were nice and interesting to see and read. I know there's at least a few that I probably missed that I wouldn't mind going through the game another time to check out. The characters were entertaining, even with Mickey's kind of derp face and Fiore's rather, Japan animu design. So gameplay, fun, decent. Story, interesting. Characters, good and decent. Yeah, I'd say this game is worth $30-$40. And it only costs $30 on the PSN when it was on sale last, so you could probably get it for pretty cheap. And then I believe, considering that it's a Star Ocean game, there's probably at least two hidden bosses that I can find somewhere. All with the higher difficulty settings and etc, etc. Yeah, that thing right there. What the hell is that? They never explained that thing right there. The circular gate. And I fully enjoyed the fact that we were not playing teenagers trying to save the world. Hell, saving the world never came into it at all. We didn't kill a god, we didn't save a world. No, we were just out to, keep rescuing our kidnapped little friend and her sister. How refreshing, from a JRPG sense. I can kind of imagine the game had very a limited budget to work with, especially during all those intense space combat scenes in which they did not show any sort of space combat. They just kept it all on the bridge, so you got to see everyone acting intense and pressing buttons on the keyboard intensely, but all the stuff outside the ship, and hell, even the appearance of the outside of the ship, never appeared. Must not have had the CG artists available. Well, I didn't even have to defend the universe from a crooked old man that harnessed the power of lollies. It was just defend this rival, or defend this military or sovereign force not part of the Federation that's currently undergoing a coup d'etat from said corrupt old man. I think the limited combat might have been because this was actually originally a PS3 game that also got put onto the PS4. Like in Japantown, you can buy Sarshin 5 on PS3 and PS4. But to include all the stuff in the game, they probably had to limit some other things for PS3 disk space size, maybe. Also, I haven't done everything in this game yet. I still have so many skills to unlock and specialties to find somehow. I think what they could have done to help the game is add more countries on the planet of Faycreed. There was the one hometown, the capital city, the other country's capital, and then random town that we took over that used to try to invade our capital. So that's like 1, 2, 3, 4 actual towns on the planet. Oh yeah, plus the in-between town, Miyadak. So yeah, 5 cities on the planet. And if you want to count the ship, it's another city. Well, I guess that's 6 total. That's quite a limited amount. And then going more into the entire medieval planet thing, as much as I said it wasn't as interesting as space, it had a couple of cool characters that they could have explored more, or interesting characters, like random jerk-ass general dude who killed Fidel's dad. Where'd he come from? I don't know, he was just kind of there, and we don't learn much about him. Or anyone from that entire military expedition. Is it worth it buying the game for full price? Not quite full price, but I don't think it's going to be sold for full price anymore, so have at it. If you're a fan of the Sarshin series, even after Sarshin 4,
Fidel's now diligently studying to become Federation's military. Truth be told, we'd already accept him as a foot soldier, but he says he won't settle for anything less than being a crewman on a battleship.
Have high hopes,
Fidel. I'm not one to balk at lending my friends a hand, but this is a battle he needs to fight on his own. Prove that I was right to believe in you and get your butt up here, Fidel.
Be a crewman. Be a random NPC.
Hey there. Your snack's ready.
Excellent. Be there when this is done.
You'll burn out studying like that.
Miki, you barely try at all. I bet you'll never transcend Emerson Aran like that.
What about just being your wife?
What did you say?
Nothing. Nothing important. I said we should both try our hardest.
Yeah, let's. Great. Finished. I'll take that snack now.
Would you like a snack? Would you like to study? Or would you like me?
And who can forget about Relia? In the aftermath of all this, the Federation Academy of the Sciences was about to effectively imprison her.
What?
Why? In the name of scientific inquisition, supposedly. Of course, Fidel and Miki were livid and planned to steal her back. Before they could do anything rash, though, Fiore and Dr. Krupp presented some interesting findings. Mainly that Little Miss Sunshine's presence was not necessary for the Academy's studies to continue. With the threat of living like a lab rat now behind her, Relia resides peacefully under Fidel's custody. I can only hope she finds happiness as a normal girl.
Meanwhile, elsewhere, who knows where? Still wearing the winter outfit.
Thanks a lot, Fidel.
So are we gonna have a picnic here, or?
Dear sis, I couldn't be any luckier.
Translator's note, Finn means the end. Continuing your adventures in the internal sphere, load the data you saved after arriving at the deepest recesses of Cornus' sickle, return to the entrance of that parallel dimension, and then transport to the Charles C. goal. Load the data you saved after arriving at the deepest, blah blah blah, return to the entrance. All the way back to the entrance? Oh, come on, man. What a dick. Well, alright, there you have it. Star Ocean 5. On a scale of 1 to worth it, I'd say it's worth it. Damn it, where the hell are my Valkyrie profile soundtrack options? I got that DLC, damn it. Oh, whatever. Alright, thank you all for watching. This has been a video production. I'll be uploading all of these three recordings, I think, to the YouTube channel, so anyone that wants to watch it again or hasn't seen it can find it there. And after this, I'll probably try to see what I haven't done in the game so far, and then probably focus on Witch and the Hundred Knight, since I'm close to beating that as well. So, I have to go all the way back to the main entrance? Really? Really? God. Then let's see, I should probably start sleeping dogs sometime. All of those other three games that I randomly got. Just to see how they were. So yeah, there'll be more stuff to see here on V2. Oh man, I even have to fight all the enemies again. And I can't escape. So, long story short, if you like what you've seen here, feel free to follow the channel, so that you can get an email update whenever it's live. And hell, I'll even do Starship 4 sometime when I can get back to it. I'm going to get my PS3 back during the middle of November, I believe. And then after that, I just need to figure out the streaming device that I need to get in order to properly stream it. And won't that be fun? But yeah, I am missing some things here in this game. Namely... where is it? 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm missing 4 specialties, and what's this? Cast off your mental shackles and increase your maximum character and skill levels. Limit Break! I don't have the skills. 10,000 SP for that. God, this game takes so much SP. Well, I enjoy this game. I would like there to be more of it, actually. But that ending seems fairly, complete. Even if the game did better commercially than it actually did. I don't think there would be any DLC for it, since Square doesn't seem to be into that sort of thing for their JRPGs, at least. Oh well. But I think I played Starship 2, 3, and 4. As well as this one, and I would say Starship 2 is still my favorite. This one is probably my second favorite now. I like it better than Starship 3, even. It's good to see Trius actually still doing things. Kaboom! It actually did a pretty good job at making the combat so seamless like it is.
Looks like I'm gaining on my
On your father, yeah, about that. Let's see. After I stop this, I believe Nautilus will be streaming something soon. World of Final Fantasy, maybe? I think so. On his Switch channel. But you can see that on the V2 main page at videovideo.net, which also will display all of our Video 2 streams, as well as contains links to all of our other fun stuff like the YouTube channel and the Facebook group and all that. As convenient as the Twitch channel is, the V2 main site is the ideal way for watching anything YouTube related. Can't believe they're making me go all the way back to the beginning of this area. This is finally the entrance. Can I leave now? Hey! Okay, we're good. So now we just leave Big Bad Evil Dude in his other dimension and peace will reign everywhere. So alright, that was Starshin 5. Not 100% complete, but the entire storyline. Thank you all for what?
Oh. That's it. That's how it went.
Congratulations.
Thank you all for watching, and good night. Good morning, good afternoon, whatever time it is, wherever you are. The end.